everyone. It's Deb, and I'm doing another etch-all project for the wedding, so I thought I would share with you. I've put the vinyl on three sides because it's very intricate, and so I didn't want you to have to sit through all of that. So I'm going to show you the last piece. I'm just going to set this here to help hold this. Actually, I'll put it like that. There we go. Okay, so I've cut out my pattern on the Cricut. Actually, Angela did these for me on her silhouette because I wanted a specific pattern and I didn't have it, so she did it for me. So I'm peeling off because I want to use the negative, not the positive. So I'm peeling this off, and you could set this aside and use it later. I probably won't, but I wanted to show you that you could. So, see if you wanted to use the pattern later. It's really pretty. So, I'll set it aside here. Okay, so now I've got my negative pattern, and I'm going to peel this off. And when you're using a large pattern like this, that's intricate, it's very tricky to peel off and not have it stick to each other. So just go slow and like I've shown you in other videos and I'll show you again, you may have to cut a little bit. Okay, so my pattern is out and I'm going to put it on here. Now I want it to be lined up with this one. So let's see. Very tricky, like I said. So we're going to put it on about right here. And I start in the middle, and then I smooth my edges down because you want to be able to get your pieces to line up when it's intricate like this. And that's very, very difficult. And as you see, they all stick to each other. So all right, so the next part I'm going to do is this upper part because it is so finicky. So I'm going to lay it down a little piece at a time and see how that's got a bump now. So I got to lift that back up and lay it smoothly down.
This time.
see it's filled in. Okay, so now I'm gonna look on the other side, and like I've shown you in other videos, I'm just gonna start pressing with my finger really hard to make sure that all of the lines are, there's no bubbles. I don't know if you can see inside there, but there's some bubbles. So I gotta get rid of all of those. So I'm gonna press really hard, especially around the edges of the cuts, because I want those to come out nice and crisp and clean. So let's get all that done. Okay, so I've put my fingers all over there. So now I'm going to take a napkin with just a little bit of alcohol, because there's a couple of pieces that you can see on here that have to go in the centers. So I want to clean it up so it'll stick well. Okay. So I'm going to go over the top just lightly, because you don't want to pull that vinyl off, but you want what you have to stick. So push that back down. All right, so now I'm going to stick my pieces in. And let's see. It's going to go there like that. And this one. Now, not all the pieces are going in, because some of them were leaves and you want them left out. Let's see. This one goes here. Again, your little tool might help you with this, because you can grasp it and lay it down easier. Actually, I think, I know it's not the right place, but I think I'm going to put it over here anyway, because it'll fit better. And no one's going to notice that it's not exactly the same on all sides. And this last little one here can go there. There we go. And no one will know the difference that there's two switched. Well, unless they were to inspect it, but I can't imagine anyone that's at a wedding is going to inspect it that close. All right, so I have all my sides covered. And I'm going to put my tool away for right now so I don't lose it. And the next thing I'm going to do is use my etching cream. It's Etch-All Etching Cream Reusable Glass and Mirror. Again, you can purchase it at etchall.com. And I really love these big bottles because they last so long. Like it says on the front, it's reusable. So I'm just going to put a little bit in the cap, because I want to be able to control really precisely where this goes. I don't want it to go outside of any lines. So I'm going to start. I'm just going to check, double check, make sure everything's sealed before I start. And that needs to go down. That needs to go down. Down. Okay, I think everything looks good to proceed. Okay, so I'm using a makeup sponge. And I'm just going to take it, dab a little bit on. You don't want it to drip too much, so be careful. And I'm just going to start applying in a good thick coat in the areas, and be sure not to get it outside of your vinyl. If you want to be really safe, then I would recommend using painter's tape. But doing 12 of these, I don't have the time to be messing with extra steps. So I'm just going to be super careful. Get it everywhere I need it to be. Like I said, I want a pretty decent thick coat on it. And you may have to do two different sides at a time instead of doing all four like I have on here, so that it doesn't drip on you. And I think that's probably what I'm going to do. So it'll take a half hour instead of 15 minutes, because once you get it on there, then you got to let it sit for 15 minutes. Okay, so let's do one more side. Again, make sure you get a good thick coat because you want it to really etch good and it's reusable so you can scrape it off. Okay. Okay, being really careful in this area, just kind of dragging it with the sponge just slightly. I don't want it to go over the line. Okay, and now that has to sit for 15 minutes, and then I'll do the other side, and that'll sit for another 15 minutes, and then I'll be back. Okay, so I'm back. I've done one side, and now I've got the cream on the other side. And as you can see, it dripped a little bit, which is why I said don't stand it straight up. I can't find my squeegee, so I'm just going to use this card, and we're just going to scrape off as much as we can and put it back into the jar because it's reusable, which makes it an ultra, ultra cheap product because you can use it over and over. So I'm just scraping off all the excess here. And normally, I have a squeegee. Oh, excuse me. That came with it, but I can't seem to find it. Oh, at the moment. So I'm just using some scrap cardstock. It actually was a card that came from in the mail from Time Warner Cable. And we don't use their products anymore, so I decided to just use this. Make sure you get all that goodness back in there. Okay. Now, after you've done that, you want to wash it off. So if you'll give me just a second, I will be right back and we'll continue. Okay, so I'm back and I've rinsed the entire thing. So now we're going to take our vinyl off. And I'm going to use my picker thing again because there's some spots that I think are going to be hard to get off. So first, let's take the easy stuff. Looking pretty. I still feel like I'm where I'm supposed to be. But don't forget to remember me. Tonight I find myself kneeling by the bed to pray. I haven't done this in a small sometimes in this big old place. Okay. Now you can see how pretty that's turning out. But you can also see here, I didn't rinse it well enough, so there's a little bit of the cream on there. So I am going to go wash that and I will be right back. Okay, so I'm back and I want to show you how beautiful this turned out. I hope you can see that. So this is going to be filled for the wedding. We're going to have a light at the bottom and then flowers coming out. So I want to do a little bit of decorating to it, not too much because the flowers, you know, you don't want to overwhelm the flowers. But I bought these beautiful pieces. Angela ordered them for me, and I don't know if you can see that, but it's kind of a bronzy peach color, and her colors are peach and mint. So I'm going to attach these, and if you can see, I had them join like together where the long line was. So, because you couldn't cut out one whole piece, it wouldn't have been workable. So I'm going to put this here like that. So the way to do that is with E6000. And if you don't have E6000, in the States here, it's pretty cheap. I don't know what you can use in the UK, but this stuff will like be waterproof and last like forever. So that's why I'm using it. Okay, so I need to find my two places. Put that in the middle. I'm gonna let that dry for just a couple seconds before I move to the other side. I'm putting a good amount on here. The back of it has like a little indent, and I'm completely filling that indent in. I think I got too much on that one. Don't want it to slide. Yeah, it's sliding a little, so I'm gonna take it back off and wipe that before it dries. Stick that back on. There we go. Okay, so that's going to take a few seconds to dry. And let me clean this up. Okay, I'll be back as soon as I get the other side finished and I'll show you the end result. Okay, so I finished the base and I've attached my embellishments, and I just wanted to show you how gorgeous that turned out. I hope you can see it well. And you'll have to wait until the wedding to see it with the lights and the flowers in it. But in the meantime, I will take some still shots and put them up on my blog as well. But I think it just turned out elegant for the wedding. Thank you for watching. And don't forget, you can order at etchall.com to get your etching cream and your vinyl and your picker. And then you're good to go. The vase I just got at the dollar store for $1. So, yeah. Doesn't cost much to make it. Remember, this stuff is reusable, so I can probably make, I don't know, 200 vases out of this jar. But anyway, thank you, and I hope you enjoyed the project. Yeah, I know there's more important things, but don't forget to forget to remember.